there is a disturbing report out of Ukraine. According to the Ukrainian intelligence, the Russians are gradually pulling their people out of an area that's contested, the area with a big nuclear power plant. Now, the Russians have accused the Ukrainians of attacking this area and vice versa. Now, the Ukrainian intelligence is saying that the Russians are pulling out. You don't know who really to believe in this whole situation. I will say that the Russian minister, foreign affairs minister, foreign minister Lavrov spoke out and said that his impression is that the West, NATO, they want to freeze the conflict to buy more time for them to send weapons into Ukraine. This is sort of like what happened years ago when they had this Minsk agreement. And it was all just designed to just buy the West time to bring in more weapons to really prepare Ukraine to take on the Russians, to threaten their security. That was basically what they were trying to do. Ultimately, I think there's people in the West who want to dismantle Russia. They want to use its natural resources. They want to use Russia like they're using Ukraine. And some of you guys definitely disagree with me, and that's fine. But I will say this about the whole World War III situation. When the bombs are dropping, you will not be invited into those bomb shelters. You will not be invited into those bunkers. Okay, so you can defend the whole neocon ideology all you want, but you're not going to be invited in those bunkers. The people you're trying to defend, the people in DC you're trying to defend, they don't care what happens to you. Okay. All right. The Supreme Court rejected Biden's student loan relief plan for the borrowers. Biden, of course, trying to appeal to young voters. This was shot down by the Supreme Court. I get the frustration that a lot of young people have. People say that, well, you know, if the government's willing to bail out Wall Street and big corporations, why won't they bail me out? I understand where they're coming from. But the fact of the matter is, the madness has to stop. You know, when you have trillions of dollars in debt, at some point the madness has to stop. Stop bailing out the corporations. Stop bailing out individuals. When you go to college and you sign up for these loans, you have to make an intelligent decision as an adult. Okay, you have to make that calculation. Is this degree going to lead to a job that produces enough money for me that allows me to pay back this debt and actually live the lifestyle that I need or lifestyle that I want? That's a question you have to determine, okay? You have to make that intelligent decision on your own. Affirmative action, that was shot down by the Supreme Court. So it was mostly an ideological vote, 6-3. They decided to go against allowing affirmative action. Look, the bottom line, I've talked about this in a short with affirmative action. You have to have consistency. You got to decide what your story is. If we are equal and we should be judged by the content of our character, then race shouldn't be a factor in deciding whether somebody gets into a college or not. We got to decide what type of country we really want to be. All right, some people made some comments about RFK as far as guns. Yeah, he said that if Republicans and Democrats came together on a consensus to support an assault rifle ban, he would sign it. Obviously, I don't support that at all. I don't see why you can justify signing a bill simply because Republicans and Democrats came together and they're willing to sign it. They're willing to pass it. Because what about the National Defense Authorization Act? What if there's some? What about the Patriot Act? What about some of that stuff? You know, just because Republicans and Democrats agree doesn't mean it's a good idea to actually sign it. But hey, I don't agree with Robert Kennedy Jr. on everything. Okay, obviously I don't. He's on the left. I'm more on the right. But compared to Biden, I think it'll be a much better option for the country. Much better than Harris. Better than Newsom. I look at Newsom and I look at DeSantis, and I think, okay, you got one guy who's running California, another guy who's running Florida. Where would you rather live? Newsom's a slick guy. He's a talented politician. He said he can work a crowd, I'm pretty sure. But, I mean, realistically, that's just a question I would have right up there. All right, so how concerned are you about this whole Ukrainian nuclear power plant situation? Do you think this might be the beginning of a false, you know what, operation? On which side, Russians, Ukrainians? I mean, what do you think is going on right here? I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, frankly, the Russians are winning this situation. They are gradually destroying the Ukrainian forces. So if anybody launches a false flag, it's not going to benefit Russia. So why would Russia do that? You got to look at that situation the same way I look at the Nord Stream pipeline situation. Okay, so how would the Russians benefit from that, from blowing up their own pipeline when they can just shut it off? Okay, one of the things I'm concerned about is bird flu. I'm concerned about this because I'm reading this article from the New Scientist, and they're talking about how there's certain mutations in these viruses, in the bird flu viruses, that might help it spread to humans, human to human type of contact. Now, I was concerned about that situation involving cats in Poland because that strain was different than the strain that was killing birds in that area. So that shows some type of mutation, the strains, you know, you just need the wrong strain developing, the wrong mutation developing, and you could have a really serious situation. So that's something I'm definitely keeping an eye on. And one of my concerns about the whole COVID situation is it didn't have a high kill rate or anything like that. And the government, a lot of governments around the world completely overreacted in a way that where they just stifled, completely suppressed people's freedoms and ruined lives, really. I'm concerned that if something serious breaks out, something with a high kill rate, I'm talking, you know, 10 people get infected and 3 or 4 die, that type of kill rate, people might not take the precautions. They might not trust the government. They might not trust the experts because experts were so wrong about everything. Well, about a lot of things, I should say. They were wrong about a lot. And the worst part is that they didn't even admit when they were wrong. So, all right, Trump is calling for peace in Ukraine. That's one of the things I like about him. It was one of the things I like about RFK Jr. So I don't have to agree with him on all issues. When it comes to the Second Amendment, I didn't agree with the fact that Trump came out and supported a ban of bump stock because of that situation in Las Vegas. I didn't support that either, but I got to look at it in the lens of, okay, how can we prevent nuclear war? That's where I'm at right now. It's not just an issue of, oh, I have to agree with everything that this politician represents. I'm at a point where it's like, okay, which politicians are least likely to start World War III? And that brings me to Donald Trump and Robert Kennedy Jr., all right? That's where I'm at. Doesn't mean that I agree with these people on everything. Or you might just think that, hey, these guys are just controlled opposition, and I completely get that. I'm frustrated with Trump for sure. Are we beyond the point of no return? Probably. The empire can't be saved, but maybe America, the country, the people can be saved. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.